Hey, what's going on, everyone? Good Mic Work Commentaries back at you with another mic drop segment. This one has an interesting origin. I wasn't planning on coming up and doing any videos this weekend. I'm actually in the middle of editing a couple of other projects that I plan to release while I'm out of town next week. But I wanted to come up here and give you guys a nice little present on this Sunday, help round out your weekend with a little bit of wrestling discussion and chatter. And I decided to come up here and do a short, separate commentary on this topic, even though I have talked about this a lot before in recent live streams. But I wanted to come up here and do a separate video on it for two reasons. Number one is that I was tagged in a tweet the other day. Shout out to Big Slow on Twitter. He was responding to someone who had submitted a question to What Culture. I believe in one of their videos, they featured her tweet about The Undertaker potentially retiring at Survivor Series next year in 2020. Because that will be the 30th anniversary of his debut in WWE when he debuted at the Survivor Series 1990. And Big Slow responded to her tweet and said that I had already laid this out in a couple of live streams and she should check me out if she's never heard of me. So I appreciate the plug there, Big Slow. But it got me thinking. And I started digging a little bit deeper and thinking a little bit more. And now I'm even more on board with this idea. And the other reason why I'm up here doing a separate video and commentary on this is because this was in my notes for my live stream on Friday night. The test run, the pilot episode, the soft opening of my new rebranded podcast that is now called the Winged Eagle Podcast. Thank you to everyone who joined in Friday night. It was a lot of fun. Pretty good audience for the first time around. It really wasn't advertised. I decided, I think, the day before that I was going to do it. So the fact that we had a pretty decent turnout for that, it was a lot of fun. And I think a lot of you guys are going to like how I start doing that moving forward. But the interesting thing is that this topic was in my notes to discuss on Friday, and I don't think we ever got into it. So I kind of regretted that, and then I thought, well, you know what? It would make an excellent mic drop, so here we are. And for those of you who do keep up with my live streams and my discussions and things like that, I have discussed this a little bit before, and I laid it out pretty nicely for an Undertaker retirement next year. And I know a lot of people are saying, Jesus, Greg, are you crazy? Another year and a half of The Undertaker? He can barely fucking move in there. Well, he's already been this far, you know, that's the way I look at it. And if you ask me, he should have been retired, you know, 5-6 years ago. But he's still out there. He basically unretired after his match with Roman Reigns, which really kind of rubbed me the wrong way. And to me, he was turning into the exact type of person that this man used to criticize back in the day when he was younger. I hope I never turn out to be the guy that hangs on too long. And I was a little bit critical for the first time in my life ever of The Undertaker in the past couple of years. I rank him as arguably the top guy in the company based on his longevity. I know Austin and certain other guys may have drawn more money, but as far as like how long he's been there, how loyal he was, and how important he was to WWE and especially WrestleMania with that crazy streak and shit, to me, he assumed the role in the void that Andre the Giant left behind. I consider him the modern day Andre when he was a wrestler. He was that godfather type of figure in the locker room that when he walked in the door, he commanded immediate respect. So I always thought that The Undertaker is untouchable. He can do whatever he wants. He can wrestle as long as he wants. Who am I to criticize the guy? But lately it's become so sad. And most recently with that debacle in Saudi Arabia, that horrific match with Goldberg that set the business back 75 years, it was embarrassing. And Undertaker, to his credit, I think he had something to prove at Extreme Rules just a few weeks ago. I thought he did an excellent job in his match. And I think in there with the right guy, even at his age and even with his limited ability in the ring, with an opponent who's not Goldberg and might be able to do a lot of the heavy lifting out there, I think it's possible for him to have a passable slash good match. And since he's already made it this far, and he's already been given the main event at WrestleMania, I've said this time and time again, I know you guys are sick of hearing it, I've been saying it for a few years now, but at WrestleMania 33, you had two titles, two world titles in that company. Both of those belts took a back seat to the Undertaker and Roman Reigns match, because that was perceived as the Undertaker's final match. WWE moved everything aside and gave Undertaker the big stage. After he lost to Roman Reigns, the only other match he lost at WrestleMania was to Brock Lesnar. He takes his hat, his gloves, his jacket off symbolically, folds everything up and lays it in the middle of the ring. He goes up the ramp and he descends and he disappears out of view. I cried that night. I actually shed a tear. The ring crew, if you remember, didn't even touch his gear. They left it in the ring as they broke everything down around him. I mean, that was an emotional moment. That was our goodbye to The Undertaker. And if that's where it ended, I was fine with that. You know, I didn't even care about the Roman Reigns stuff. To me, that was secondary. I didn't give a shit that Roman Reigns was in that match or he won or nothing. I didn't even care. To me, it wasn't about him. It was about The Undertaker. And to me, that felt like a goodbye. And I know you can say, oh, he never said he was retiring. Yeah, I know that, but it was understood that he was. Even ESPN was running stories that The Undertaker, that was the headline. Like on ESPN's website, on fucking SportsCenter, Undertaker retires at WrestleMania. So yes, he never came out and said it, but what the fuck was he doing then when he was taking his jacket and shit off? That was a retirement. I will fight anyone who thinks differently. So the fact that he came back, I'm like, well, on one hand, that annoys me, but on the other hand, like everything I talked about earlier, with his godfather status and his legendary status in the business, I don't want to be one that really judges him. I mean, fuck, he can do whatever he wants. He's given us so much. He's had one of the most amazing, arguably the most amazing career in the history of wrestling, craziest and best gimmick in the history of the industry. So, shit, if he's going to make a couple of mistakes or annoy me at the end of his career, so fucking what? At least he's not Hulk Hogan. At least he's not embarrassing himself with every single interview or family dilemma or just crazy drama surrounding him. He keeps his nose clean and never seems to be in trouble. He's not getting DUIs left and right like Jimmy Uso. His only fault, in my mind, is that he is wrestling entirely too long to where it's getting downright embarrassing to even watch him out there. And it's cringeworthy. You're sitting there, I'm usually really nervous during his matches now because I'm like, is he going to die if he takes a really, really gnarly bump? So it worries me and it frightens me. So at this point, I think the only way you can salvage his career now and have him go out in a nice way, because the fans are, you know, they're realizing now his limitations as well. And yes, he had a great match at Extreme Rules. And I think if WWE uses him in smart ways, he can still go out there and get through some matches for the next 18 months. As far as I'm concerned, he's made it this far. If he just kind of appears here and there and he can make it to next year's Survivor Series, that would be the perfect setting for his retirement, the official end. 100%, you're not coming back. And that's what I've been talking about recently. And then, as I'm thinking about this a little bit more, I start thinking to myself, what is the actual date of his debut at the Survivor Series 1990? So I looked it up, November 22nd, 1990. And I thought to myself, wouldn't it be cool if November 22nd fell on a Sunday in 2020? So I looked it up, and holy shit, sure enough, there it is, November 22nd, a Sunday in 2020. So if they book Survivor Series on that date, and that's very likely because it's not even Thanksgiving weekend. Thanksgiving weekend is the next weekend after that. And WWE usually does not book Survivor Series attached to Thanksgiving weekends anymore. They haven't done that since the beginning. So it's likely not going to fall on Thanksgiving weekend. It's possible that it could fall the week before on November 15th. You have no idea what other scheduling conflicts WWE has in their way if they have another Saudi Arabia trip planned somewhere around that time. But if you're looking in 2020 and you're looking ahead that far, how do you not book the Survivor Series on that fucking date? That's it. That's how you do it. That's how you take this beautiful WrestleMania retirement that The Undertaker was gifted and ruined. This is how you fix it. It's really the only way you do fix it. Try to stretch it out at this point. I know it's been a long time, but I think if we're just a little bit more patient and we can hold out for just a few more months. I think I said 18 months earlier. I don't even think it's that long. I think it's more 15 or 16 months. And we can make it to November of 2020. I think that's where you do it. And I've been talking all this time. We haven't even mentioned an opponent. What do you guys think? To me, an opponent is almost irrelevant. I think his opponent has to be meaningful. I don't want to see him go out like Kurt Angle, where he's losing to Baron Corbin. Jesus, I hope nobody from WWE is listening to this, Can you imagine that? Baron Corbin retires Kurt Angle at WrestleMania and then retires The Undertaker at Survivor Series on his anniversary. You think that guy ain't going to be annoying on the mic? Holy shit. So I guess we better be careful what we wish for here, because that could happen. But also, you know, in all seriousness, I don't think it really matters. I think it would be more about The Undertaker, the final goodbye. It's going to be about him. He should lose, I believe, if he wants to win. Fuck it, who cares at this point? But I think he should probably go out and maybe just do some fun shit. Bring everybody that you can think of back from his past. It would be so great if Paul Bearer was still alive. But I think Kane needs to be involved. I don't think Kane needs to be his opponent. I want the match to be somewhat good. So I think he will need to be in there with a current guy. I think Roman and him had a decent match for what it was, but it was not good. Definitely not good at WrestleMania. So I don't know if you put him in there with Roman again, unless The Undertaker feels bad about ruining that retirement. And so he says, I'll job to him again. But I think that would be better suited for someone else. What about The Fiend? God, I hate that nickname. But Bray Wyatt, who knows where he'll be in a year from now? He can either be the hottest star the business has seen since The Rock, or he can be chasing around Drake Maverick for that 24/7 title. Could go either way there. The Demon Finn Balor would be another fun possibility. He could certainly bump around for The Undertaker. I've been pitching a big push for Drew McIntyre. I thought they might even be setting up for Drew McIntyre and The Undertaker at SummerSlam, but it doesn't really look like that's going to be happening. Unless they throw it together or something. So maybe Drew is in that position by then. Who knows? A lot can happen in a year. But if WWE is trying to think of some sort of a scenario for The Undertaker to finally have his final goodbye, that has to take place somewhere. He does eventually have to have a final match. You know, unless he just wants to wrestle till he dies and his final match is never known that it's his final match, I would hate to see 30 years of The Undertaker's career go by and you don't even have a proper send-off or goodbye. That would break my heart. So I think you're running out of possibilities here, you know, and if you let this go by, if WWE lets their stupid schedule get in the way and say, oh no, we're not going to put Survivor Series on that weekend because we have something better to do, we're getting more money to go over here. Fuck your money. Give The Undertaker this date. It belongs to him. And let us all say goodbye to him the right way. It's what he deserves and it's what we deserve. So, WWE, do this shit, man. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. What do you think about the idea? If you want to give me any storyline twists, if you want to throw some fantasy booking at me, I'll be happy to read those comments. You know, if you want to go further than just trying to decide who The Undertaker will face at that show in his final match, book the storyline. Tell me how the angle will go. How would you do it? How would you introduce his opponent? How would the match go? Who would win? All that shit. Give it to me. Lay it out. Go nuts. It's the weekend. Why not? Let's have some fun. If you also have ideas for this, you're welcome to shoot them over to me on Twitter. Go follow me, by the way, at GoodMicWork, and let me know over there as well. So anyway, thanks for hanging out and discussing this, and let's all hope that I'm right. And next year at Survivor Series will be the final resting place of the career of The Undertaker. Y'all be good. Peace.